All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Erica Williams. She is the CEO of the Yumy Candy Company. And Erica, it's great to see you. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Glad to be here. Thank you.
Yeah, excited to learn more about your company. This is really a company that kind of started because you were looking for something and couldn't find it and wanted to create something. So maybe take me back to the beginnings of this company.
For sure. Yeah. No, I've been in the health and fitness industry for years. Very passionate about human health, coach people online, and really was in the industry working on, new product innovation, seeing what was in the market, but really just that pulse on what consumers are looking for. And, you know, going back a couple of years, I mean, people have definitely become more conscious of what they're putting into their body. I think, especially in the last 2 years with people staying at home more, but really where it started was that need for innovation, that need for something new and fresh. Obviously we're in the confectionery industry. So, you know, that's kind of hasn't been innovated on in the last, 20, 30 years. When you think about your childhood favorite candy, there's those big main ones, but there's not a lot of new players. So we're very proud to be a new, fresh, innovative company that's very nimble and really, pride ourselves on listening to the consumers, listening to, not only what they're wanting today, but what they're going to be wanting in the next 5 years.
Erica, when you did that research, were they saying they want something that is lower in sugar, but also not going to bust the bank? Because it seems that that's the niche you're kind of playing is that a little healthier option with a little less price.
Exactly. This came from, really talking to people and understanding that, people are going to come for, the health benefits, but they're going to eventually stay because it's a good tasting product and it's affordable. They can actually use it every single day. When I think about, families that use our product, it's moms, it's families, right? They're giving it to their kids. You can't be, you want to have a premium product, but you don't want to pay the premium price because at the end of the day, you won't be able to afford, having that on a daily, weekly basis.
So your first product was the Yumy Bear. And am I correct when I was reading that you basically cooked this at home to try and figure out how to put this all together? Is that you sort of played with this over a year?
Yes. Yeah. My background is in nutrition. So of course, when I was coaching people, doing my own healthy lifestyle, I baked a lot of things at home. I really started in my kitchen and I was innovating and coming out with different, I have a sweet tooth. Anyone that knows me, it's, I have a passion for health and fitness, but I love candy. I love sweets. So I was really trying to find something that I could have that I could feel good about putting into my body, that sat well with my stomach. So when I was innovating, we wanted it to, of course, be low sugar because that's been a trend for a number of years, right? With growing people understanding how sugar impacts your health, and then also vegan. A lot of people, over 60% of consumers, say that they're trending more towards a plant-based diet. So I wanted to make sure that we could create a gummy without gelatin. So it took a lot of trial and error, and very quickly after our first couple of renditions, we took it to a full kind of industrial kitchen and started really cooking up some wonderful items to the product that we have today, which is just a great tasting, amazing texture product.
So where you were to that point to where you are now, what kind of growth have you seen within the company?
Oh my goodness. It's been crazy. It's been a wild journey, and very exciting. I'm really thankful for everyone that's been along on the ride because it has been such a crazy growth. We came out with our flagship product. We launched two SKUs, the strawberry kiwi and the peach flavor. And then we launched the sour watermelon flavor last summer. And we just announced that we are launching a new yummy soda line, which is going to be three new flavors as well. We got into London Drugs. We really scaled up across Canada in a very short amount of time. And with partnering with the right distributors, the right partnerships really allowed us to have that huge expansion. And really what it came down to, what I was seeing at the store level, the consumer level, is the demand for it. And that's what I think when you think about how companies expand, if there is a product that people love, that they're continually going to the store and buying, you can expand quite quickly. And that's what we're seeing is people are wanting something different. They're wanting something new. They want something that tastes great, but also has all those health side benefits. So we got into London Drugs, we were in Save-On Foods. We just got into Loblaws as well. So we're in the major retailers in Canada, which is very exciting for the company. And now with doubling our SKUs, doubling our expansion of our products, really we're just getting started, but it's been a great journey so far for sure.
Is that sort of what the plan is for 2022? You've got these new SKUs, as you mentioned, is driving those while continuing to see the original product driven as well. How do you sort of grow things in the next year?
Yeah, for 2022, we have a lot of great expansion plans. One of the major ones, of course, is continue to expand across Canada, grow our sales across Canada. Right now, you know, the major players like Haribo, Hershey's, they've been around for a lot of years. They're starting to innovate, but we really want to capture that market share very quickly. And I think we are accomplishing that with our product and the partnerships that we do have. So expanding to bigger retailers in Canada, coming out with a new product line. So we have the Yumy Soda coming for this year. And then we also have R&D on multiple other SKUs as well. So very quickly you'll see, the Yumy Candy Company is expanding into multiple different, you know, types of candy and confectionery products. And then US expansion is on our docket for this year as well. So that will be an exciting, you know, huge push for the company because, you know, the Canadian market, it's amazing, but the US market is, obviously a huge player. So we're excited to expand into that market, and we've already started those conversations and partnerships. So that will be probably one of the biggest things that we undertake this year.
And lastly, obviously we speak to investors. And so can you talk to that sort of it and why the company would be, at this particular stage, right, for investors to see the kind of growth that you're talking about?
For sure. I mean, as a consumer and where I put my money into companies I believe in. I believe in the mission. I believe in the product, spreading more of what I want to, what I would consume myself, what I think should be out there in the world. So we really want to provide an opportunity for people, even everyday investors to do that. And we are the first and only, pretty proud to say that, Better For You confectionery company be publicly traded. So it's a great opportunity. There's nothing like us. We're at this stage where we're expanding very rapidly. So, it's a great opportunity for people to invest into a company that they see a ton of potential growth in. And this market, the sector that we're in, the Better For You confectionery space, it's not a trend. It's very much growing. It's just at the infancy. I like to attest to, we're all familiar with the plant-based meat market. Yeah. It's kind of grown in the last 5 years, right? I remember when plant-based was, uncooled to just put it frank, right? And now we've seen that growth in the last 5 years. It's such a trend. So we've seen that in other sectors like the meat, like the dairy industry, and we're seeing it now in the confectionery industry. So to be a part of a company that's at this stage is a unique opportunity. And I definitely think, sky's the limit. We're only getting started.
All right, Erica, thanks so much. Appreciate the update. Congratulations on your success so far. And we look forward to following your story.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great day, you guys.
Yeah, you as well. There's Erica Williams, the CEO of the Yumy Candy Company.